welcome to this special series we're calling The Second Wave. In the series, I'm going to be going across the country to meet up with CEOs representing different companies to find out how things are looking, how they have restructured and reworked their plans after what has been a tough year, year and a half, and most importantly, if the green shoots of growth everybody is talking about is proving to be something more lasting, more discerning, perhaps a second wave of growth. We kick off the series here at the Infosys campus. This is a company that comes out with numbers first quarter on quarter, and of course it is a company that is seen as a bellwether representing the once bustling Indian IT sector. They've gone through a rough patch, the whole sector, so how is this company really grappling with the time? For the company and the IT sector it represents, the last 2 years have been tough. 2008 was one that saw pretty much everything go wrong. Icons collapsed, there was a credit freeze, economies took a dive, and the services export story that had put India on the world map seemed to be unraveling. For Kris Gopalakrishnan, who took the reins of Infosys as CEO in 2007, it has been nothing short of a baptism by fire, made even more challenging because he took charge from predecessors and friends who had been so charismatic and successful that they had led the company to the top of its league. But as one of the original team, Kris has managed to keep the mega house in order. But how are things looking now? Kris, thank you so much for joining me today on The Second Wave. Really, is the worst over?
It looks like the worst is over. It's behind us. There are signs of recovery. When we talk to our clients, they also believe that the worst is behind and the future looks better. Different industries are going to emerge out of this at different pace. You know, they also went into it at different pace. So they're going to emerge out of this at different pace. We are seeing signs of recovery in, for example, financial services. We are seeing signs of recovery in retail. Manufacturing seems to be a little bit slower. So different industries are going to emerge at different pace.
What, according to you, has been the trigger for this? Is the fact that governments have been very proactively throwing cash at this crisis and hence we've had a bit of a recovery?
Definitely, the coordinated, investments which governments have made clearly has probably, reduced the impact and accelerated the recovery.
Are you seeing this across economies? Because from the news that we have heard, Japan, France, Germany, all of them have shown signs of a pickup. Are you seeing this across economies?
We are seeing this across US and Europe. Japan, our visibility is limited at this point, our business is limited in Japan, but clearly we are seeing this across US and Europe.
Why then, Kris, is Infosys giving out such a conservative estimate of the year ahead? You've always been conservative, but this is the first time in years that you'll actually show a decline in sales. What's making you so circumspect?
See, nobody was able to predict this, the downturn, right? And how fast the downturn happened. I still remember we had one of the best quarters in last year, 2008. Second quarter was one of the best quarters, 7% sequential growth. But then the world fell apart after September 15th. And nobody predicted that. And that's the reason why I want to, and we want to be circumspect at this point. We want to be cautious at this point. We want to wait and see and make sure that the recovery is real and it's going to be sustained. There are still concerns about, for example, commercial real estate in the US, concerns about credit card defaults, concerns about bankruptcies in small and medium enterprises. So there are still concerns and it is better to be conservative.
So it's better to be safe than sorry, and that's why you're conservative?
Yes.
Or are you seeing signs of stress within your clients that, they might have weathered the storm, but they are very wary of looking at expansions, etc., for the next couple of quarters?
I think they will be. They will be wary for a couple of quarters. In fact, when we did the survey, most of them said that beyond March of 2010 is when we start spending the money. So that means they will have at least two quarters of results, and that will give them the confidence to start spending.
I'm very curious, after a year like this, how have your key clients in the BFSI space changed mentally and with their strategic vision? Because, I don't think anybody would have foreseen the scale of the crisis.
So the strategy will probably come later. Right now, they're focused on, making sure that their operations are as efficient as possible, clean up those parts of the business that are not operating very well, or maybe, not strategic for the long term, trying to generate some cash by selling some assets and things like that. Focusing on risk management. Risk is very, very important because that's what caused the problem. So there is a lot of investment happening in risk and things like that. So that's what is happening in the financial services sector. Now, there are other things that are happening in different sectors. For example, in retail, there's a shift happening from print media to digital. So that's a very interesting transition. So different industries are looking at different things during this downturn.
Right. On the whole, is it fair to say that the crisis didn't turn out to be as bad as the prophets of doom were predicting it to be, at least for the Indian IT space?
See, the initial thought was that this is going to be a prolonged downturn. So in that sense, I think it's a pleasant surprise that recovery has happened very quickly. So we didn't expect this downturn to be as bad as this. We didn't expect the recovery to happen so soon.
A lot of people are saying that the upturn that we are seeing right now could be a false start, and we might see a recovery more shaped like a W, with this being the first hump rather than a straight V. Would you agree with that? Do you think that's pretty much how we're going to go?
That's where the uncertainty is coming. Is it a W? Somebody is saying it's like a bathtub, a bottom which is elongated and then an upturn. So different theories are floating around, and that's why we are circumspect at this point. We don't know.
So do you think an artificial cheer at this point might be a little, out of the way?
No, you have to be cautious because there could be, false starts and things like that, and it could be a W.
Right. Kris, we'll come back after this short break and talk about how the company itself has restructured after what has been a tough year and a half, and how you have handled things, considering that you took over at the most difficult time for the company. That's after the short break. Stay tuned.